Good morning everyone. In the previous slide, in the previous class, we have studied about the producers, consumers and decomposers. Okay, these are the components of biotic structure. Okay, so what do you mean by producer? Who produce their own food? Okay, they are called as our producer, and the main, the green plants are the producers. In forest, trees are the main producers. Okay, so they only produce the food. Okay, next is our consumers. Who are the consumers? We are the living organisms who are fully dependent on the producers for our food, are called as our consumers. Okay, because we cannot synthesize our own food, or we cannot produce our own food. So we people are dependent on the producers, like plants. So, and also animals are dependent on plants. So we are consumers. And next one is our decomposer, who decompose it. Okay, in an ecosystem, these are called as our, who are our bacteria, fungi. These are our decomposers. So the consumers again subdivided into two. First one is our macro consumers and second one is our micro consumers. Okay, so now I will teach you about the macro consumers. Okay, so micro consumers again, it's subdivided into three. First one is our primary consumer, second one is our secondary consumer, third one is our tertiary consumers. Okay, so what do you mean by primary consumers? What do you mean by that? These are also called herbivores, which feed directly on producer, for example deer, giraffe, goat, cow, etc. Because these are the plants, which these are the animals which are directly dependent on the plants. Okay, because they are the vegetarians and they only have the plants products. Okay, the leaf, these are they have it as them, they have it as their food. So they are fully dependent on the plants. So they are our primary consumers. Okay, understood. So some primary consumers in the African savanna are rhinoceros, elephant, giraffe, zebra, the same goat, cow, deer. Okay, next is our secondary consumers. Who are the secondary consumers? So these are also called as carnivores. Okay, so they cannot digest the producers, hence they depend upon the primary consumers. Okay, so for example, wolves, cat, snake, etc. They are not have the plants products because they cannot digest it. So they are fully dependent on the primary consumers. Okay, so the examples of primary consumers are wolves, cat, snake, etc. So we know that the wolves, they cannot have it, so they are directly dependent on the primary consumers. The zebra is a primary consumer because they can only have the plant products as their food, but the lion can have them, the lion can eat them. So they are the secondary consumers. Bear, shark. Okay, so they are our secondary consumers because shark and whale, they both are hitting the primary consumers because the small fishes, which they are having the small plants or phytoplanktons which are present in the river or water or ocean or in the river in water. Okay, so they are the primary consumers, and the sharks, the whales, they are dependent on the primary consumers. So they are called as our secondary consumers. Okay, understood. Next is our tertiary consumers. So in certain ecosystems, from organisms depend upon the carnivores, that is the secondary consumers, for their energy source. Sometimes tertiary consumers are they depended on the secondary consumers because they cannot have the primary consumers. Okay, but they also get the primary consumers, but in some times they dependent on main, especially on the secondary consumers, for example tiger, lion, crocodile, etc. So they are the our territory consumers. So examples, some of the examples of territory consumers are eagles, great white shark, big cats. So they are our territory consumers. Understood? So mainly our consumer is who we cannot produce his own food. They are mainly dependent upon the producers. Okay, so again our consumer is subdivided into two. First one is our micro consumers and second is our macro consumers. So our macro consumers is again subdivided into three. First one is our primary consumers, next is our secondary consumers, and third is our territory consumers. So our primary consumers are fully dependent on the producers. Okay, and the secondary consumers are fully dependent on the primary consumers because they cannot digest the plant products, or they cannot digest the food directly from the producers. So they are dependent on the primary consumers. And in some type of ecosystem in which some living organisms depend upon the secondary consumers, they are known as our territory consumers, and also they are not dependent on the producers. Okay, so and they are mainly have it due for their energy source. They want to collect energy. So the examples of territory consumers are tiger, lion, crocodile, etc. Okay, next is our decomposer. Mainly decomposer means who decompose. So these are the living component of the ecosystem. These are also the living organisms and living component which break down complex compounds of dead protoplasm of producers and consumers to simple inorganic compounds and ultimately into inorganic nutrients. Okay, so the role of decomposer is inevitable as they are responsible for completion of ecosystem mineral cycle. So these are also known as micro consumers, saprobes, saprophyte, and saprotrophs. So in the previous topic consumers, we have heard about a word micro consumers. So our decomposers are also known as micro consumer, and also these are also known as saprobes, saprophyte, and saprotrophs. And decomposer have a great role to complete the cycle because producer directly get the energy from the sunlight, then the consumer intake the food, and the decomposer are here to decompose it, and again from the decompose they can the from that again it return back to the producers. Okay, because after decompose it, the nutrients are get stored in the soil, and the producers, the plants, also get the nutrition from soil. Again the same cycle is rotating. Our producer, then consumer, then decomposer, again return back to the producer, consumer, and decomposer. So these three are the main important component of our biotic structure. First one is our prime producer, second one is our consumer, and third one is our decomposer. Okay, understood everybody? And remember always that producer is also again subdivided into phototrophs and chemotrophs, and our consumer is again subdivided into micro consumers and macro consumers, and our macro consumers again subdivided into primary consumers, secondary consumers, and territory consumers, Then is our decomposers, which are also called as micro consumers. Okay, thank you.